Our first speaker is Jason McCool. And he's gonna, that's right. Give it up, man. And he's a cool MC Jazz. And Jason is an actor, musicologist, professor, and Twitter evangelist who loves to get people into some really cool music. Go for it, man.
And we're off, I hope. Thanks for being here.
Magic is happening.
In the 13th century, a remedy was suggested for malaria, which included the ear of a cat, blood, brandy, and pepper. The treatment of malaria has come a long way since. However, for those thousands of people around the world, like myself, afflicted with the obsessive condition known as malaria, we are not quite as fortunate. We collect recordings, we read biographies, we travel to places Mahler might have stood in. And why? Because in his music, Gustav Mahler connects us with life's big emotions. But before I talk about Mahler, I want to talk about you. You are passionate, you are ambitious, you are spiritual seekers in a world that gives you prepackaged answers. You want to maintain your independence. These are the very same problems Gustav Mahler faced, and his music lives out the solutions. Mahler was obsessed with love. He was surrounded by death his entire life, and he turned those obsessions into some of the most gut-wrenching classical music ever written. But I'm going to guess about 50% of you are thinking, classical music is boring. So I have three letters for you. ROI, return on investment. I know a lot of you guys are involved with finance. I wish I were more involved with it. And I love ROI because it's the same thing with classical music. The more you invest, the more you will get. Everyone loves classical music. Okay, Gustav Mahler, born 1860, close to Prague, Jewish, converted to Catholicism to get a job, ended up confused, put that confusion into his music. Famous as a conductor during his life, but his music was mostly laughed at. He wrote 9.5 symphonies and a lot of songs as part of turn of the century Viennese culture. Mahler is a bridge figure between Romanticism and Modernism. Leonard Bernstein called him a prophet, said his music predicted the violence of a century of war. Now his music sells out concert halls and has more relevance to our time than it did to his own. If you've ever heard a film score, you've felt Mahler's influence. Here's where you should start, along with my favorite recordings. The first symphony is loaded with drama and passion, great melodies. Mahler 2 will melt your face. Mahler 5 is like being on a roller coaster during a lightning storm. The First Symphony is probably the first place you should start. It begins with a single note, A, spread out over 7 octaves, then falling fourth figures, which mimic the sound of birds. On October 16th, I gave the pre-concert lecture for the Capital City Symphony. Please, someone in the orchestral world, hire me. You know, I was listening to Mahler 1 while doing dishes recently, and this, seriously, universe gave me this gift. Mahler 1 is ultra-concentrated joy. It will powerfully rinse the grime from your soul. Mahler composed the most epic music you will hear in your life. Yeah, he wanted more cowbell, but in his sixth symphony, he also wanted a giant hammer, the triumph of the human spirit over death. Mahler 2 is so epic. Mahler 2 is so epic, it makes Freddie Mercury look like Freddie Mac. My notes say hold for laughs, so. But seriously, folks, don't believe everything you read on the internet, but believe this. I consider Mahler's Resurrection Second Symphony to be the best piece of music ever imagined. If you haven't heard it yet, run out to a record store and get it. By the time it's over, you'll be completely broken down in tears, sweating from exertion, and paralyzed with rapture. Gilbert Kaplan is a Wall Street economist who attended a concert of Mahler 2 and was so moved he quit his job and dedicated his life to learning how to conduct this piece even though he had barely any previous musical training. That is the effect this music has on people. The Adagietto from Mahler's Fifth Symphony, Leonard Bernstein conducted this at Robert F. Kennedy's funeral. La da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da. In July of 2010, I sat at Gustav Mahler's grave outside Vienna for 30 minutes. I thanked him for his music and for what he contributed to this world. I invite you to join me in seeking Gustav Mahler, and I thank you for your time.